Sorcerer's Stone. Let's talk about it. How do we feel about it?
This is where we all found out that Dumbledore is kind of bullshit.
In the first movie, you sniff it.
Yeah.
What's up with this guy?
The first movie, nigga, you sniff it, bro. You go, hey, this principal kind of ain't shit. And we're going to get, nigga, as we go on to this, you're going to find out Dumbledore really ain't shit. But this is the first movie you sniff it out like, this nigga ain't shit.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, I guess he's like somewhat, but like, okay, if you have the most powerful thing in the, one of the most powerful things in the magical world, right? The Sorcerer's Stone. Mm-hmm. Why would you put it under your school?
Wasn't it in Gringotts to like begin with too?
Yes.
And then he's like, which was supposed to be the safest place.
Yep, it's the bank.
Yeah, he starts off because when they go to Gringotts at first, Hagrid picks up the stone.
Yep.
Yeah. And it's like, why leave it? Why? Why?
You wanted all the smoke, bro.
Yeah,
I get that. He's like, oh, but he's setting up what he's supposed to do at the end. Hey, bro, why are you putting all these other kids in danger? You fucking animal. Who are you? The fucking schools now?
Yeah.
I went there.
Yeah, it's like you're waiting for this first year to save the day? You're the most powerful wizard in the world. You're the most powerful wizard in the world. How is it that at every turn you need this kid to save you?
Oh, bro. This nigga, Dumbledore, in Chamber of Secrets, right? Just so we can combine, because they kind of lead into each other.
Right.
This nigga in Dumbledore in Chamber of Secrets sends a bird. He sends a bird. He knows Harry Potter is down there with the snake and with Voldemort. He's like, oh, I know this is happening.
Yeah.
I can transport anywhere like that because I'm fucking Dumbledore. Hey, bird, go. I know you have the power to kill the snake. Don't kill it. Scratch its eyes. Let's see what Harry does.
Yeah. Well, Dumbledore at that point, isn't he? He's in prison, isn't he? Or no, he's been expelled. Or he's been like sent away. Something's happened.
That nigga still can. He sent the bird.
He can also go, just travel really quick. That's all what the I'm time. Saying. He does it all the time.
Shit. It makes no sense. It's like, hey, why are you testing? Yo, Harry is also 13 in Chamber of Secrets, nigga. Or 12.
Right. Oh, he's 12. He's 12.
Yeah.
And you're like, hey, go fight Voldemort. Because Tom Riddle's Voldemort, nigga. It ain't like Tom Riddle is fucking Voldemort. And he has to go fight that nigga. He has to go fucking fight him at fucking 12 years old. And the principal knows, hey, I'm going to send a bird. Dumbledore, you ain't shit. Let's not even get. Oh, what? Because I know what I want to say next.
But just say it.
Nigga, in the Sorcerer's Stone, this is how you know Dumbledore ain't shit. And nigga, we talked about this, and I'm going to say it right here. Mm-hmm. If you are in Ravenclaw or Hufflepuff,
or especially Slytherin.
Or Slytherin. Your freshman year. This is your freshman year. That's what this is. This is your motherfucking first year, bro.
So after they.
You know you're all there to win the House Cup.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's the whole point of Sorcerer's Stone, nigga. They really hammer it in Sorcerer's Stone that this shit is about winning the House Cup. Houses get points. You know, you can lose points, get points. Nigga, Slytherin's up.
One by 160, by 150.
150 points at the end of the movie. They got their banners up, nigga, like they won the ring. They might as well be the fucking Raptors. They have the championship. Banners up, you know? And then this nigga Dumbledore stands up, and what'd he do? What'd he do, yo? What'd he do? Don't even, what'd he say?
He gave 50 points to Ron.
For what?
For winning chess.
Chess?
Yeah. He gave 50 points to Hermione. For, I guess, I don't know.
Potions or some shit. Potions,
yeah, keeping stuff. Everyone calm or some shit.
She did some kind of potion shit.
Yeah.
50 points to Harry.
Harry
For bravery, because he's fucking Harry.
Well, which is crazy that he gave Harry the same amount of points for defeating the Dark Lord as he did Ron for winning a chess game.
Because I'm looking, if I'm Harry, I'm like, damn, nigga, that's both 50, huh?
Yeah.
I had to defeat the Dark Lord.
Yeah.
The back of a nigga's head morphed into Voldemort. I had to burn him with my hands. And I'm traumatized forever at 11 years old. And 50 points, huh?
And then he gives,
how's he wrap it up, Sam?
He gives 10. He gives Neville 10 points because, quote, anyone can stand up to the enemies, but it's harder to stand up to your friends. Because Neville tries to stop them from leaving to go to the Chamber of Secrets.
They take down the Slytherin banners
and
put up Gryffindor. So, my nigga, this is This is what we were talking about. Look, so okay, so that happens to you your freshman year. You're immediately, if you're in any of the other houses, you're like, oh, bro, this shit's rigged.
Yeah, this is bullshit.
This
yeah.
is bull. They're gonna do whatever for Harry, bro. They're gonna do whatever for Harry. So, yo, this is my impression of a nigga in Ravenclaw, like 3 years later. And he's talking to a freshman. Like, oh man, I hope we get the house cup. Oh, bro. Nigga, hit this shit. Yeah. Let me tell you what happened freshman year, bro. Let me tell you what happened my freshman. Let me tell you how you never gonna win house cup.
Yeah.
I saw them niggas give Harry 150 points just cuz. Awesome. We don't even know shit, bro. And the whole school was in danger.
Yeah, they endangered the school give Harry points.
Also, everyone in Hufflepuff, we decided, smokes weed.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, everyone Hufflepuff smokes weed. Hufflepuff fucks. Hufflepuff is the place to be.
Yeah, Hufflepuff's the party house.
Because you know in Hufflepuff, what they like, you realize if you went there, anyone there through the Harry years, I'm sure the other years are fine. Anyone there through the Harry years were like, oh, bro, this is all fucking rigged.
Dude, the people that are in Harry years were probably looking around like, why the fuck does our entire school revolve around three kids?
Nigga.
Why the fuck does that happen?
I mean, Sam talks with, yo, oh, bro, imagine being you. So I'm their Sorcerer's Stone year. That's my senior year. Mm-hmm. I'm Ron Weasley's. I'm that nigga. I'm the RA. I'm the oldest dude at the bitch. I'm about to graduate. Mm-hmm. And I find out these three freshmen keep losing us points.
I'd be so pissed.
Nigga, we beating their ass. Like, no, we're it's confronting. We're going up to them like, hey, bro.
Yeah.
This is my senior year. I'm trying to win House Cup. And y'all out here fucking looking for shit. Looking for problems. First two movies, looking for problems. Now let's get to the third movie, Prisoner of Azkaban.
Sorry, what were you going to say, Sam?
Oh, we didn't really go through the second movie.
Yeah, we didn't talk about the second
one. Let's go to Chamber.
We didn't talk about the second one at all.
Chamber next.
I would say that this applies to all three of the first movies. The first three movies should be called Hermione Granger and the Sorcerer's Stone, Granger and the Chamber of Secrets, Hermione Granger and
kicking
the Prisoner
ass.
Of Azkaban.
No, not even. The third one, Hermione Granger straight up kicking ass. Because Prisoner of Azkaban, she's Jordan in the third, like, where he's just in his bag.
Yeah.
Where he wins that third championship and he's just like, oh, he's the greatest player alive right now.
They need her for everything. And in the first movie, when the troll attacks her in the bathroom, she covers for Harry and Ron, even though Harry and Ron were assholes to her,
yep,
because Hermione is a straight gangster, bro.
Yep.
Yeah.
Under, like, everyone loves her, still underrated.
She is, I mean, yo, HG, bro. It is the Hermione Granger story.
She's like Uma Thurman in Kill Bill.
She's fucking Uma Thurman in Kill Bill, dog. She's such a leading woman. It's crazy that no one doesn't talk about how much she saves the day in all the movies.
She can't
also in all the movies. Because in the other movies.
In the second one.
What happened in the second one?
That's the one where she, like.
She's petrified.
She's petrified.
But the way.
Nigga,
but the way that she's petrified gives away the entire mystery. Like, they are able to figure out the mystery because they see how Hermione's petrified. That shit is crazy, dude. She, even when she's incapacitated, she is fucking making buckets. She is hitting buckets, dude.
Yo, she is insane. Yo, it's insane how great when you rewatch them, especially the first three. Because the first three, Harry and Ron don't do shit. Them niggas don't do shit, bro. They do a little bit. I mean, Harry kills some things.
What? Harry's brave.
Harry's super brave. But Hermione does everything to get him to that point.
Yeah.
He's stupid brave.
Sometimes you want to just like slap him. He's like, what do you know about wizarding? You just got
here. Yeah, he'd be talking shit sometimes. And he'd be like, Harry, shut the fuck up, bro. Just let Hermione. Hermione should be the only one talking and leading the group.
Yeah, I remember in the first movie when Ron gets hurt in the chess game, when there's no reason for him to ride the knight. He's riding the knight in the chess game. There's nothing that says he has to ride the knight in the chess game.
Nope.
Never had to do that.
So he's riding the knight. He gets knocked out.
Fucked up.
And then Hermione's like, Harry, you go. You're a great wizard. And it's like, no, Hermione. You're the great wizard. You're the actual great wizard. Harry's only a quote-unquote great wizard
because
everyone tells him he's a great wizard.
He's famous, mm-hmm, bro.
There's nothing that shows until he actually defeats Quirrell, which he doesn't defeat Quirrell. Quirrell, like, touches his face and he disintegrates.
And he disintegrates.
Yeah. Which is not any skill on Harry's part.
Just circumstances.
Circumstances, and I mean, it's fucked up for an 11-year-old to have to do.
Yeah, yeah. But
like, the principal should definitely not have put him in that situation.
Yeah.